News Live 10 at 10 continues with No Wait Weather.
All right, a lot to talk about tonight. The headlines weather-wise are the wind warning for our western counties. Winds have gusted over 60 miles per hour, and some of these winds have buffeted even the Red River Valley counties. So up there near Cavalier County and down not far from Lisbon, we have gusts that have approached 60 miles per hour yet this evening. Winter weather advisory for northern portions of Minnesota, by the way. More on that in just a moment, but right now, look at those wind gusts today. 67, the peak wind in Rapid City. But even here in the central portion of the Dakotas, between 55 and 66 miles per hour, that peak wind recorded in Oaks today. So very gusty winds. And some of the strongest winds are just now buffeting the Red River Valley. 52 mile per hour peak wind in the Fargo-Moorhead area. Now, these are rather small, but generally we're seeing wind gusts right now over 50 miles per hour through Fargo and through the southern Red River Valley, including Fergus Falls. A lot of folks in Fergus are asking, how windy is it? Well, what wind gusts are exceeding 45 miles per hour there as well? Out in the woods, a little bit less as far as the gusty nature of the wind, but it's still very strong for you as well. The cold air moving in, 20s to the west, low 30s here in the southern Red River Valley, and we have low 30s as well throughout all of western North Dakota. The SkyCam and our roof here in our studios shaking and baking thanks to all these gusty winds, which are at 51 miles per hour right now. So things like garbage cans, your lawn furniture, if you will, maybe you have a table out on the deck or something, you may want to secure that because winds this strong can cause those things to fly across the yard. It feels like 17. That's what we call the old wind chill, 33, the temperature at Hector. Isobars are very friendly up here in Winnipeg. Strong winds blowing across the prairie there, and we see the tight pressure gradient through the Red River Valley as well. Notice the isobars a little farther apart in the Bismarck area and out west. Winds are starting to decrease out there, but for now, it looks like it will remain windy and now white. We had some snowballs, if you will. Little snowballs work their way through the Fargo area. That's called grapple. Some of that now moving into Lakes Country out to the east. Now we are seeing some rain making its way into Duluth, but a little closer examination showing some showers of snow working their way through northwest Minnesota. This slides down through Thief River Falls. Here we start to see some darker bands, Norman County, Manoman County, and out towards the eastern reaches of Clay County. Holly, the darker blues there, meaning more of that likely even reaching the ground a little bit. So a brief dusting of snow working its way through. And oddly enough, we're getting these bands of snow setting up out in the central Dakotas where the cold air is moving in. We get this little wavy action in the atmosphere where we have that cold air, and that kicks off some more flurries that sometimes persist for some time. Good news is a lot of this blowing and snowing is taking place as we head to bed. But by morning, notice things don't change too much. The isobar is still friendly. Gusty winds won't be up to 65 in the morning, but still over 40 miles per hour. With areas of snow, northwest Minnesota could have some difficult visibilities in open country. Use caution, give yourself extra time, and slow down because we could have accumulations there. Temperatures in the 20s, feels like temperatures in the teens for most of us throughout the day. Wind decreasing by the evening as this system finally exits the region. Late, a blustery and cold day. Fargo 25 to start the day. Winds gusting to 45. We'll see gusty winds persist through the daylight hours. 33 degrees, your high temperature in the afternoon with any snow chances leaving us behind. 20s north, low 30s south, and your planning forecast shows the cold takes hold with morning lows in the single digits up north and teens for Friday morning, for Saturday morning, but then Sunday. We return to upper 30s, which is above average for this time of the year, and 40s early next week.
It's quite a night out there tonight.
A wild, windy Wednesday with white conditions and wet conditions, depending on where you are.
Wow. Jingle bells, snowflakes, and longer lines at the register. Still to come, why experts say that could be the case this holiday shopping season.
And local nurses weigh in on the perception of their profession after some national criticism. Stay tuned.